गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। हेलो
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
ऑन द सेम ग्रुप आई हैड पोस्टेड द वे योर इन्वेस्टमेंट मैनेजमेंट असाइनमेंट्स हैव टू बी सबमिटेड। व्हाट हैपेंड इज आई हैव चेक्ड सम ऑफ द असाइनमेंट्स टुडे मॉर्निंग एंड आई केम अक्रॉस दैट एवरीवन इज डूइंग द वे दे वांट इट। I will not accept it. There has to be uniformity, and in order to create uniformity, I have prepared the way you are going to submit your assignment. So it is a group assignment. Okay, please open that PPT. See what is there in that particular PPT that I have floated, and accordingly you have to put your data in that particular format and send it to me in MS Word. Many of you are sending the Excel files as it is. Okay, there are formulas attached to it. When I open it, I don't get the answer. I get some discrete values because there is a formula that is attached. So in order to remove all those errors, whatever answer you get, whatever graph that you have drawn, copy the same, put it in a MS Word format. Okay, what has to come on page 1, what has to come on page 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. All are mentioned in that particular slide. So please check that particular slide and accordingly revert back to me. Is that clear? This is one part. Second is, your assignment for tax management is yet to be received. I have still not received your assignment for tax management. Remember, I had told you to solve all the problems, 21 problems on income from capital gains. And what are those problems? Which solutions I have given it to you? You are just supposed to understand it and solve that particular questions as a part of your assignment. Remember, I have not received that also from all of you.
We have sent you the tax session.
No, I have not received from everyone.
Sir, we have sent you the email ID what you have sent for the investment. The same email ID we have
sent. Rohin, you have sent it, but there are others who have not.
Yes. Okay.
So this is the last warning from me to all of you, because ultimately by the end of November, we have to evaluate that particular assignment. So if I receive it in that particular date, it's well and good. Otherwise, you have to forego that particular marks for that particular assignment. That's one. Second, I hope DGK sir has sent you the revised academic calendar. Okay, so your term is going to be extended till January also, okay, which is in one way good because I have a lot of things to get to cover up. And you also have ample time to study, and I hope the exam schedule is also has commenced. The exam schedule has come, so please be aware that your exams will be held. No doubt about it, your exams will be scheduled as per the academic calendar that was floated. Yeah, so please make a note of this. In this class, I want to discuss about equity valuation. I had also given the PDF to you. I wanted you to download that particular PDF, okay, and once I start discussing it, that particular PDF has to be in front of you. So it is generally advised that you open your laptop if you have it, open the solved problems in front of your laptop or PC, and you can hear me on your phone. If you are using the phone, you can hear me on your phone, or else you can use the laptop itself. Clear? So right now I'm going to start sharing the PDF screen of the problems that we are going to understand. Okay, prior to that, just a couple of things that I would like to tell you about equity valuation. Okay, so I'll first switch on the PPT for 5 minutes, and then we'll go to the problems part of it. Clear? Yeah, any doubts up to this particular point so far, whatever we have discussed?
No, sir.
I've been getting calls from many people. Okay, I don't want to name them, but a lot of people are not cooperating as far as group assignment is concerned. Remember, you have given me the names. I know who are the people, in what group they are, and what are they supposed to do. Your job is to coordinate with your group members and submit the assignment. If you don't do, the entire group will lose the marks. Then don't blame me. That's the reason I have clearly mentioned it's a group assignment. If one person in the group does not submit his or her part of assignment, the entire group is going to lose out. Don't blame me that, you know, we three have done it, but the fourth person did not cooperate. That is not what I'm here for. That is, you have to manage him. Okay. So please ask everyone, those who have not willing to do it or who are not in a position to do it for some or the other reason, saying that I don't have a laptop or I don't have a PC. You have ample time to roam about in the entire city that you live, but you cannot arrange a laptop to do your assignment. I will not tolerate this. Okay. So those who have not done it, do it. Okay. One fine day, if I open it, if I don't get the relevant data, all those people who have not submitted it in the way that I have told you will lose marks. Then don't blame me. This has gone on recording. Okay. So it is not that I have not warned you anything. Is it clear? So please take things seriously now.
Okay. The submission date.
Submission date has already passed, but still I am giving you 2 more days. Anyway, you have done that, right? You have to just copy paste it in the required format.
Yes, sir.
Submit it to me. That's it. So today is 25th, 27th November. I require the assignment. Those of
okay,
you
sir.
Who can't do it, that means you have not done the previous assignment also. Very simple. It is just a copy paste, nothing else that you have to do. Clear? Fine. So I'm switching on to the PPT first and then I will switch out to the PDF file. Okay. We are talking about equity valuation and in that there are a couple of modules that we have to understand as far as equity valuation is concerned. But what is important is the theory that we have to understand as far as equity valuation is concerned. Whenever we talk about equity valuation, you have to take into consideration that whenever we are valuing something, we are doing the valuation for someday in future. Priyanka, can you please mute it? So whenever we do any valuation, we do it always for the future. We do all the things, all the valuation that is done. Okay, we do valuation for the future. Okay. So whenever we do valuation for the future, we have to understand that we need to take into consideration the present value of that particular valuation. We need to know what is the value of my share today. It might be 1,000 rupees 10 days or 10 years down the line, but what is the present value of that particular share today is very important. And whenever such questions have been asked, the concept of discounting comes into play. The concept of discounting cash flow models comes into play. Okay. So under discounting cash flow models, there are two main models that we have to understand. One is called the two-stage model and one is called the three-stage model that we have to understand. Now, what happens in a two-stage and what happens in a three-stage is what we have to understand in detail. Understand one thing. I'm talking about the two-stage model. Okay. Of course, when we come to the details of two-stage model, I will tell it to you. But in general, I would like to tell you one thing. Always remember, whether it is for equity, whether it is for a share, whether it is for a company. Initially, when the company starts, okay, the company is going to have, I hope all of you know that all of you have studied the product life cycle.
Yes, sir.
So if you observe any company that starts, takes a little bit of time to settle in the market first, and then it has a very high growth rate. Can you see this growth rate? It has a very high growth rate. Okay, it has a very high growth rate. And after reaching that particular growth, then the growth slows down. So if you observe, if I have to draw a line, something like this, you have a straight growth in the initial years, then the growth remains flat or there is no further growth. You tend to maintain at a constant rate. So this is the first stage of valuation and this is the second stage of valuation. So when we combine these two, we get two-stage model. We get two-stage model. Clear? So in the two-stage model, what happens is the company initially will have a very high growth rate, okay, for a certain number of days or certain number of years. And once that particular time passes by, the company will not have a exponential growth, but it will stabilize and move in a horizontal way. That is what we call as a constant growth. Clear? And this growth is for indefinite period. Unless company does something drastic, either it will go up or it will go down, depending on whatever decision the company takes. So when we have or when we experience such companies, the model that we are going to use is called a two-stage model. On the other hand, there are companies who experience a three-stage model also. Okay. Now, what happens in a three-stage model? First of all, the company grows at a certain level. Something drastically goes wrong with the company starts falling down, then they take some corrective actions, and again the company starts growing in a horizontal way. Okay, if I have to plot it on a graph, it is something like this. Okay, the company has already stabilized. Okay, the company has already stabilized, and I'll just explain to you. This is the two-stage model. Okay, this is a two-stage model. So this is stage number one, and this is stage number two. So this is a two-stage model. Now what happens? Now what happens is, this will grow for a certain number of days. Then the company is going to experience some competition from somebody else. If they don't make any corrective decisions, or if the management is lethargic, the company will still follow or still go on this particular path for some days. Then something drastically goes wrong with the company. The company's growth starts falling down. Okay, it falls down. Then people realize that, you know, something is terribly wrong with the company. And when they realize that there is something terribly wrong with the company, they take some corrective actions. And because of their corrective actions, the company starts growing in a horizontal way. In other words, the further growth or the downfall is stopped. So this is what we call as stage number one. This is what we call as stage number two. And this is what we call as stage number three. So first, we have a two-stage component. And then we have a three-stage component. Are you able to understand? This is applicable for each and every company that is coming in the market. You have to just identify in which stage that company is. If you are able to understand in which stage the company is, accordingly, those relevant models can be applied. So if it is a company is in this particular stage, you can apply two-stage formula. If the company is in this particular stage, you can apply the three-stage formula. Clear? So this is what we mean by the valuation of equity shares. Okay? And whenever we do these valuations, whether it is for two-stage model or whether it is for three-stage model, always remember, we have to find the value of the company as of today. So whenever we find value of the company as of today, present value plays a very important role. And present value is nothing but you are going to discount the value. So that is the reason it's called discounted cash flow models. Clear? So as I said, what's going to happen in the two stage, what is going to happen in the three stage are all mentioned here. For your simplicity's sake, just go through these two points. Okay, and then we'll switch on to the problem part of it. Just go through this three points. Done with it? Have you gone through it?
Yes, sir.
Now, whenever we have to understand the two-stage model, we have to find the value of equity. Value of equity is nothing but P. Okay, P naught, which is mentioned here in the formula. This is what we want to find out. And when we want to find out what we have to understand, we have to take into consideration the present value of free cash flows of the enterprise. Okay, free cash flow of the enterprise at a high growth rate and find out present value. Okay, then we have to find out the formula where then we have to find out the present value of growth when the growth is stable. So this is this particular part, this part is stage number one. This part is stage number one, and this entire part is stage number two. So when we add one and two, we get a two-stage model. Clear? Now, what is important for you is to understand this particular formula, okay, and understand the notations for this particular formula. Clear? Anyways, what we are going to do is I'm going to stop here. I will switch on to the PDF file wherein the problems have been mentioned, and I will start with those problems itself. So this is a two-stage model formula. Okay, so this is a two-stage model formula here. Okay, and this is a two-stage model formula, and these are the notations for that particular formula. Okay, so you have it with you the PPT, but see to it that you also study this particular part, because understanding these formulas is very important. Okay, again, from your exam point of view, this is a 10 marks question. This is a 10 marks question from your exam point of view. Clear? So now let us see the problem, a simple problem on how do we understand the concept of two-stage model. Yeah, somebody can you please read this? Somebody please read this.
So that Nagarjuna fertilizer stock.
Yeah.
So can I read?
1 minute. Yeah, you please read.
Yes. According to Financial Express report, October 2020, the rate of return of Nagarjuna fertilizer stock for the past 5 years is 18.58%. This is assumed to be continued for next 5 years. And after that, rate of return is assumed to have a growth rate of 10% indefinitely. The dividend paid for year 2019 and 20 is 18%. The required rate of return is 20%. The price is rupees 14 on 14th October 2020. Estimate the stock price according to second stage model.
Okay. Now, if you read this problem very, very carefully, it says the company is growing at a rate of 18.58%. It is growing at a rate of 18.58%. This is what is clearly mentioned. Okay. Next, what is it mentioned? Next, what does it talk? It says this is assumed to continue. It says this is assumed to continue for next 5 years. Right? This is assumed to continue for next 5 years. That means you are going to have an initially a growth of for next 5 years, the growth is going to be 18.5% here. And after that, the growth is going to fall down. Because if you look at the problem, it says after 5 years, the company is going to grow at the rate of 10%. Initially, it was growing at 18%. Now it will grow at only 10%. That means there is a fall in the growth of the company, right? And because there is a fall in the growth of the company, we have to estimate what could be the price of this particular share with relevant other data, like what is the dividend that has been paid, what is the required rate of return. All those things are mentioned to us, right? Using this particular data that is given in problem number 11.6, we have to estimate the price of equity share using the second stage model or the two stage model. Okay, now please, while you're solving, first step is please write down the formula and write down the notations along with those values as for your calculation purpose. Now for all practical purpose, D naught is 18%. Okay, it is 18%, but here I have written it as 1.8. Can somebody please explain to me why is it in this particular way? Why have I written 1.8 here?
Sir, GS means it's above normal growth rate. Right? It's in percentage. So we have, for easy calculation, we have converted into in decimal, sir, 0.185 multiplied by 100.
No. See, if 18.58 was there, then why have I written 18.58 rate here? I have written 18.58% or 0.1858. That option is available to me. But what is D naught? Why I have written D naught as 1.8? From where did I get this value is my question. Remember, I had told you something. I told you what is Can you remember what I told you? Face value of the share. Face value of the share. What is the face value of the share? Face value of the share will always be equal to 10.
10. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And, okay, dividend. And dividend is equal to how much percent? 18%, right?
Sir, 18.
Dividend is 18%, right? Sorry, just give me a minute. Dividend is 18%, right?
Yes, sir, 18% it is.
So if dividend is 18%, okay, just excuse me, dividend is 18%. Dividend is 18%. So what is 18% of 10 rupees? What is 18% of 10 rupees? Is 1.8, right? Are you there? Are you able to understand what I'm trying to tell you?
But you are not audible.
So we can't hear you.
Please check it now.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Thank you. What is 18% of 10 rupees? 18% of 10 rupees is 1.8, right?
Yes, sir.
1% of 10 rupees is 1.8. So from, if you understand now from where did I get this value, it is dividend. D0 always stands for dividend. Okay. So the, in this part, okay, can, if you are able to see this, D0 talks about dividend. And this is a dividend rate that we have. So how did I get 1.8? I got 1.8 because 18% of 10 rupees is always 1.8. So growth is given to me in the problem. So growth, I have written it as it is, no change in the growth. Whatever the growth is given to me, I'm using the same growth rate, okay, to find out the price of the share. Is that okay? Now, you have two growths. As I said, one growth is where, you know, you have one growth is, for example, it's a normal growth. So this growth that we have, 10%, we call it as a normal growth. Why do we call this growth as a normal growth? Because it is told to us that the company is going to grow at 10% indefinitely. The company is going to grow at a growth rate of 10% indefinitely. So when the company is growing at a growth rate of indefinitely, that means it is normal. So that is the reason I consider GN as my normal growth rate at 10%, and GS, there is a word here called as GS. Okay, so GS is above normal growth. So I have two growth rates. This is my required rate of return, 20%, which is given to me. Time given to me is 5 years. Now, using these values, I just substitute the values and I arrive at the valuation of my equity share. And how did I do it? First, I considered only the first part of the formula. I considered only this part of the formula. Okay, so that is my step number one. So I write down my formula here as step number one, and I start using or start solving this particular part. Okay, at the end of this particular solution, I get answer as 1.8. I get the answer as 8.68. Clear? You have to try it out. You have to practice it. Only then this comes. Just by looking, mere looking at these numbers, you will definitely not understand what is happening here. Okay. Next part. Next part is, just a minute. Next part is, I have to solve for the next part. Dn plus 1, the whole divided by Rs minus Ng. Yes.
Sir, can you please repeat the previous problem, sir? I mean, we couldn't see the screen, sir, so I didn't really understand.
Which one?
So the previous one.
This one, right?
So the same, yeah. This one, sir.
Yeah. See, if you look at the formula, Rashmi, okay, you find one, I'll just enlarge it so that it's visible to you. Yeah. If you just look at this particular formula, you find that there is one G here. Okay. There's one, is one concept, you know, concept called as GS here, okay, and there is one growth called as GN here. So you have two growth rates. This growth rate you are going to use as an exponential growth rate, which is nothing but 18.58%, which is given to you in the problem. We call it as a super normal growth. So GS stands for super normal growth, that is 18.78%. And this is the normal growth, which is nothing but 10%, which is given to us in the problem. So I have two growth rates. One growth rate is a supernormal growth rate at 18.58%. The second growth rate is at GN, that is 10%. Okay, all other parameters are given to us. So I substitute the values of all these parameters and I try to find out the answer for this particular question. That is step one, I try to find out the answer. Clear with it, Rashmi?
Yes, sir.
Next, step number two, I have to find out the next part of the formula, that is dn plus 1. Now, please understand, dn plus 1, so the explanation is available here. Okay, only thing is you don't know how to arrive at this. Now, dn plus 1 is, what is the dividend after n plus 1? Okay, what is the dividend after n plus 1? What is n, what is n in your case? For how many years you are going to have a growth rate of 18.58%? For how many years you have a growth rate for 18.5%? You have a growth rate of 18.5% for 5 years, which is mentioned to you in the problem. Now, after the 5 years get over, what is going to happen? The company is going to fall down, right? The growth is going to fall down. So if the growth is going to fall down, when that fall is going to start, that fall is going to start after n plus 1. What is your n? N is 5. Clear? So dividend at in the fifth year, the dividend is going to grow at 10%. So that is what the calculations talks about. So we have to use DN plus 1. So what is going to be your dividend at the...
Sir, it should be...
Yes?
Sir, that small n, it should be capital N also. D capital N plus 1.
Sorry. That is D capital N. Just make a mistake. Just there is a mistake there. Don't worry. So N is your...
Yes, sir.
Now it says DN plus 1, which means at the start of the sixth year, N is 5, right? So 6, 5 plus 1, 6. At the start of the sixth year, what is going to happen? Your company is going to grow at 10%. Your company is going to grow at 10%. So that is DN plus 1 concept. Now from where did I get this 4.2201? Okay. You solved this part. So when you solve this part, this is going to be your dividend at the end of fifth year. This is going to be your dividend at the end of fifth year. So only when you solve the numerator part of it, you are going to land up with this particular answer of 4.2201. The same 4.2201 I have considered here. Why? Because if I have to calculate my dividend from the sixth year onwards, I need to know what is my dividend in the fifth year. So this is my fifth year dividend. I use this particular concept. This is my fifth year dividend. I use this as a base and try to find out the dividend in the sixth year. I use this concept and try to find out the dividend in the sixth year. So my dividend in the sixth year is going to be N plus 1. That is N is 5. So 5 plus 1, 6 is equal to whatever is the dividend at the end of fifth year plus 10% of that. Why? Because the company is going to grow at 10%. Thereafter. So 4.2201 into 1.10. When you solve this, you get only the answer for the numerator part of it. So when you solve this, this is your DN plus 1 value. Okay, so DN plus 1 is equal to 4.642. So this is your answer for the numerator. Okay, and you know what is your RS? Required rate of return is 20%. Normal growth rate is, yes, Narayan?
From where that 1.10 came?
10% is the growth rate?
Yes, sir.
Right. So your question is from where this 1 came, right?
Yes, sir.
See, always understand, whenever you're talking about growth, we have to say the base year. You have to consider one base year, and from that base year, you have to calculate something else. 10% of what? There has to be something for 10%, right? Okay, you are not able to understand. Fine. How do you calculate? Narayan, how do you calculate? What is that? If I ask you to calculate future value of 100 rupees 2 years down the line at 10%, what will you do, Narayan?
I don't remember that formula, sir.
Narayan, you should know all these formulas. If I want to find out the future value, okay, future value is equal to, what do you write? You write present value into 1 plus R, right? Raised to N. You write present value, okay, into 1 plus R raised to N. This is what you write here. Don't worry as of now, because it will be, I'm using a different tool here. But if I have to just show you, I'll just stop sharing the slide. 1 minute. How do you calculate future value, Narayan? So future value is equal to, present value into 1 plus R raised to N. This is what you do, right? So if my present value is 100 rupees, 1 plus my
Screen, sir, screen is not visible.
You better come to college. That is better for me. Just a minute. Yeah. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Quickly, because I have less time now. So I want to calculate future value is equal to present value into 1 plus r raised to n. This is a formula to calculate future value, right?
Yes, sir.
If I ask you to calculate, Naren, tell me what will be the value of 100 rupees that I have today, 5 years down the line. 5 years down the line, what will be the value of 100 rupees if rate of interest in the country is at 8%? So if my r is 8%, what will be the value of this 100 rupees? What do? You write 1 plus 8%, right? You write 1 plus 8% according to the formula and solve it. So when you solve this, what happens? It becomes 100 into, how do you write 8%? This is the way you write 8%. 8% is what? 0.08?
Yes, sir.
Now, if you add this, how much do you get? 100 into bracket 1.08. Right? 1.08. Correct? Are you able to understand? Oh, do not.